Good morning and welcome back to another week of Matins in the Morning. It is Monday, May 20th. It is the Memorial of Mary, Mother of the Church, just a day after Pentecost. My name is Nathan. I'm joined by Aletha. We're coming to you from the St. Thomas More House of Prayer, where it is our mission to pray and promote the Liturgy of the Hours. You can find out all about our retreat center and the work that we do over at our website at liturgyofthehours.org. As I said, we're just a day after Pentecost, which means we switch prayer books. So we're no longer in volume 2, we're now in volume 3 of the Liturgy of the Hours 4-volume set. I'm going to take us through our page numbers that we'll need. You can find all this information in the description below the video as well. We're going to jump around a little bit, so if you could bear with me, we'll have our opening hymn. We'll take that from the Common of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and it will be the hymn that begins at the bottom of page 1627, and we'll be singing the first 4 verses of that hymn. Our antiphons and psalms will come from the current day of the Psalter. We're in week 3 of the Psalter, and those will begin on page 998. Our first reading and responsory will come from the Proper of Seasons. We're in the 7th week of Ordinary Time, and that reading will begin on page 232. And then our second reading and responsory is also in the Common of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and you can find that on page 1621. Because this is a newer memorial, we have a concluding prayer that's not in the prayer book, so I will include this in the description below the video as well. So we'll begin, as we always do, with our prayer of preparation for the Divine Office. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Open, O Lord, my mouth to bless your holy name. Cleanse my heart from all vain, evil, and wandering thoughts. Enlighten my understanding and kindle my affections, that I may worthily, attentively, and devoutly say this office, and so deserve to be heard before the presence of your divine majesty, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, in union with that divine intention with which you praise God while you were on earth, I offer to you this hour. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen. Alleluia. Praise to Mary, heaven's gate, guiding star of Christian's way, Mother of our Lord and King, light and hope to souls astray. When you heard the call of God, choosing to fulfill his plan, by your perfect act of love, hope was born in fallen men. Help us to amend our ways, hold the devil's strong attack, walk with us the narrow path, beg for us the grace we lack. Mary, show your motherhood, bring your children's prayers to Christ. Christ, your Son who ransomed men, who for us was sacrificed. Our God will be made manifest. He will not come in silence. The God of gods, the Lord, has spoken and summoned the earth. From the rising of the sun to its setting, out of Zion's perfect beauty he shines.
Our God comes. He keeps silence no longer. Before him fire devours. Around him tempest rages. He calls on the heavens and the earth to witness his judgment of the people.
Summon before me my people, who made covenant with me by sacrifice. The heavens proclaim his justice, for God himself is the judge.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our God will be made manifest. He will not come in silence. Offer to God the sacrifice of praise. Listen, my people, I will speak. Israel, I will testify against you. For I am God, your God. I accuse you, lay the charge before you.
I find no fault with your sacrifices. Your offerings are always before me. I do not ask more bullocks from your farms, nor goats from among your herds.
For I own all the beasts of the forest, beasts in their thousands on my hills. I know all the birds in the sky. All that moves in the field belongs to me.
Were I hungry, I would not tell you, for I own the world and all it holds. Do you think I eat the flesh of bulls or drink the blood of goats?
Pay your sacrifice of thanksgiving to God and render him your votive offerings. Call on me in the day of distress. I will free you and you shall honor me.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Offer to God the sacrifice of praise. I want a loving heart more than sacrifice, knowledge of my ways more than holocausts. But God says to the wicked,
but how can you recite my commandments and take my covenant on your lips, you who despise my law and throw my words to the winds?
You who see a thief and go with him, who throw in your lot with adulterers, who unbridle your mouth for evil, and whose tongue is plotting crime.
You who sit and malign your brother and slander your own mother's son, you do this, and should I keep silence? Do you think that I am like you?
Mark this, you who never think of God, lest I seize you and you cannot escape. A sacrifice of thanksgiving honors me, and I will show God's salvation to the upright.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I want a loving heart more than sacrifice, knowledge of my ways more than holocausts. Listen, my people, and I will speak.
I am the Lord, your God. From the book of Ecclesiastes. I said to myself, come now, let me try you with pleasure and the enjoyment of good things. But behold, this too was vanity. Of laughter I said, mad, and of mirth, what good does this do? I thought of beguiling my senses with wine, though my mind was concerned with wisdom, and of taking up folly, until I should understand what is best for men to do under the heavens during the limited days of their life. I went on to the consideration of wisdom, madness, and folly. And I saw that wisdom has the advantage over folly, as much as light has the advantage over darkness. The wise man has eyes in his head, but the fool walks in darkness. Yet I knew that one lot befalls both of them. So I said to myself, if the fool's lot is to befall me also, why then should I be wise? Where is the profit for me? And I concluded in my heart that this too is vanity. Neither of the wise man nor of the fool will there be an abiding remembrance, for in the days to come both will have been forgotten. How is it that the wise man dies as well as the fool? Therefore I loathed life, since for me the work that is done under the sun is evil, for all is vanity and a chase after wind. And I detested all the fruits of my labor under the sun, because I must leave them to a man who is to come after me. And who knows whether he will be a wise man or a fool? Yet he will have control over all the fruits of my wise labor under the sun. This also is vanity. So my feelings turned to despair of all the fruits of my labor under the sun. For here is a man who has labored with wisdom and knowledge and skill, and to another who has not labored over it, he must leave his property. This also is vanity and a great misfortune. For what profit comes to a man from all the toil and anxiety of heart with which he has labored under the sun. All his days, sorrow and grief are his occupation. Even at night, his mind is not at rest. This also is vanity. There is nothing better for man than to eat and drink and provide himself with good things by his labors. Even this, I realized, is from the hand of God. For who can eat or drink apart from him? For to whatever man he sees fit, he gives wisdom and knowledge and joy. But to the sinner, he gives the task of gathering possessions to be given to whatever man God sees fit. This also is vanity and a chase after wind. God gives wisdom and knowledge and joy to the man who pleases him, but to the sinner he gives a weary heart and a foolish eagerness to heap together riches.
This is vanity and a chasing after the wind.
The love of money is the root of all evil, and some men in their greed have brought upon themselves many bitter sorrows.
This is vanity and a chasing after the wind. From a sermon by Saint Sophronius, Bishop. Hail full of grace, the Lord is with you. What joy could surpass this, O Virgin Mother? What grace can excel that which God has granted to you alone? What could be imagined more dazzling or more delightful? Before the miracle we witness in you, all else pales. All else is inferior when compared with the grace you have been given. All else, even what is most desirable, must take second place and enjoy a lesser importance. The Lord is with you. Who would dare challenge you? You are God's mother. Who would not immediately defer to you and be glad to accord you a greater primacy and honor? For this reason, when I look upon the privilege you have above all creatures, I extol you with the highest praise. Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. On your account, joy has not only graced men, but is also granted to the powers of heaven. Truly, you are blessed among women, for you have changed Eve's curse into a blessing, and Adam, who hitherto lay under a curse, has been blessed because of you. Truly, you are blessed among women. Through you, the Father's blessing has shone forth on mankind, setting them free from their ancient curse. Truly, you are blessed among women, because through you, your forebears have found salvation, for you were to give birth to the Savior who was to win them salvation. Truly, you are blessed among women, for without seed you have borne, as your fruit, him who bestows blessings on the whole world and redeems it from that curse that made it sprout thorns. Truly, you are blessed among women, because though a woman by nature, you will become in reality God's mother. If he whom you are to bear is truly God made flesh, then rightly do we call you God's mother, for you have truly given birth to God. Enclosed within your womb is God himself. He makes his abode in you and comes forth from you like a bridegroom, winning joy for all and bestowing God's light on all. You, O Virgin, are like a clear and shining sky in which God has set his tent. From you he comes forth like a bridegroom leaving his chamber. Like a giant running his course, he will run the course of his life, which will bring salvation for all who will ever live, and extending from the highest heavens to the end of them, it will fill all things with divine warmth and with life-giving brightness. Truly, you are the most favored among women. Where Eve brought a curse, you have brought a blessing.
Through you, the Father's gift has been bestowed on us.
Through you, your ancestors have found salvation.
Through you, the Father's gift has been bestowed on us.
Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, whose only begotten Son, as he hung upon the cross, chose the Blessed Virgin Mary, his mother, to be our mother also, grant, we pray, that with her loving help, your church may be more fruitful day by day, and exulting in the holiness of her children, may draw to her embrace all the families of the peoples. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Let us praise the Lord.
And give him thanks.
We'll now conclude with our prayer that follows the praying of the divine office. To the most holy and undivided Trinity, to the humanity of our Lord Jesus Christ crucified, to the fruitful virginity of the most blessed and glorious Mary, ever virgin, and to the whole company of the saints, be everlasting praise, honor, and glory by all creatures, and to us remission of all our sins, world without end. Amen. Blessed be the womb of the Virgin Mary, which bore the Son of the Eternal Father, and blessed be the breasts which nourish Christ the Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.